Hello students,
in this class we will see our next method, that is regular falsum method or false position method. There are two names again for this method also, regular falsum method or either they can say false position method. Okay, both are same. Now let us see how to solve the problem of what is the method, what is the regular falsum method or false position method. Okay, now suppose if this is your plane, this is y axis, this is x axis, this is basic thing, you studied this in the geometry. X axis, y axis. Okay, now suppose if we are having this is our curve, if we are having this is our curve, or let us take f of x is equal to 0 be the given equation. Okay, so it possesses only one root, it possesses only one root, and again it is in the interval a comma b. Okay, now see, this is a, this is our b, this is the point a, this is the point b, so we can say this is the interval a comma b. Okay, so there is again, see, in the bisection method also, in the given interval we find exactly the one root, approximate root. So here also we have to find one root. So if f of x is equal to 0 possesses only one real root in the given interval AB, okay, and suppose if f of a, see, again here also we want f of a and f of b should be opposite in sign. Okay, in this method is in this method also, similarly, whatever we solved in the bisection method, same here we have to apply. Here also we want f of a and f of b are in opposite sign, means one is positive, one is negative. So here in this figure, let us take f of a is positive. Now see, you know, if this is your plane, x axis, y axis, here you will get minus y axis, that is y dash, and here you will get x dash. So this is positive value. We know these are also positive. If you compare, this is negative, this is negative. So we have constructed it is in the first quadrant only. So here x is also positive, y is also positive. But if you compare this, this is the first quadrant, this is second, this is third and fourth. And in fourth quadrant, we know that y value is negative. Okay, here it is negative. So if you see this, here we are having f of a. So we can take f of a is positive. Let us take f of a is positive. And here we are having this f of b. Okay, here we are having it is f of b, so let us take f of b is negative. So to solve this method, we have taken f of a is positive, f of b is negative. Only one thing what we want, both should be opposite in sign. Either you can take this is positive, this is negative. Okay, so here we have taken this is positive, this is negative. Now if you see the graph, here we are having y is equal to f of x in the interval ab. This is the interval ab, and this curve is called y is equal to f of x. So y is equal to f of x in the interval AB crosses x axis. If you see, this is the x axis. So this curve y is equal to f of x, this is the curve y is equal to f of x, it crosses x axis. It crosses x axis at only one point. And what is this point? This point. If you see, this is the curve y is equal to f of x, and it crosses at x point, exactly at this point, that is one point. And let us denote that point is nothing but r. Okay, let us denote that point is nothing but r. Now here, now we can join this line, we can join this line. Okay, this is the curve, we can join the end point of the curve. Let us take this is the point a comma f of a. Okay, because here we are having a f of a, let us denote this point and ordinate of this point c. Here we are having it is b, so b comma, because always in the geometry we denote first x ordinate, second y ordinate. Okay, always we denote x ordinate comma y ordinate. So here x ordinate is a, and this is f of a, so this is y ordinate. Here x ordinate is b, this is f of b, so y ordinate is f of b. So let us denote a comma f of a, b comma f of b, be any two points on this curve. Okay, be any two points on this curve. Now if you see here ab, this ab meets again at x axis at this point. This AB meets again at x axis at this point. This is the curve. Curve meets at this point. But if you join the endpoints of the curve, again this curve meets at x axis at these points. Let us denote that is nothing but C. Okay. Then we have to consider C is our first approximation. We have to consider C is our first approximation, or you can say first root. You know, C1 is the first root. Then we have to find the second root, again C, again third root. So here we have to consider C is our first root. Now to find the C, we have to use the formula. Okay, so to find C, first we have to find slope of AB. slope of AB. This is all geometry. And see, some of you studied this in the last sem only in the geometry. Suppose if x1, x2 and a of x1, x2 and b of y1, y2 are any two points, then slope of the line AB. Then slope of the line AB is given by y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Just you have studied in the last sem. I think commerce students studied in this in the last sem. So, slope of the line AB is given by y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So, here this is our A, this is our B. The points of A is A, f of A. The points of B is B, f of B. Using this formula, we can write slope of this. Okay, let us take this is our x1, this is our x2. Okay, x1, y1, x2 minus x1, x1, x2. This is x1, y1 and x2, y2. Then the slope is given by this formula. So, let us this is your x1, y1 and this is your x2, y2. Now, using this formula, we can write y2 minus y1. So, how we will write this is slope of AB is equal to y2 minus y1. So, y2 minus y1 means here we will get f of B minus f of A divided by x2 minus x1. Now, here what is x2? We are having B and here x1 is A. So, B minus A. So, this is the slope of AB. Similarly, we can find slope of AC. Again, using the same formula. But here now we are finding with respect to AC. So, we have to consider this A point and this C point. This is the C point. And for the C point, the ordinates are C, 0. So, now you will get this is your x1, y1 and this is your x2, y2. Now, again, if you use the formula, what you will get? Slope y2 minus y1. So, here y2 is 0. Minus y1 is again f of A. Divided by x2 is C minus x1 is A. So, C minus A. But 0 minus any number is that number itself. So, you will get minus f of A divided by C minus A. Now, since if you compare, we are having slope of AB is equal to slope of AC. Slope of AB is equal to, I will write here, since well, we know that slope of AC is equal to slope of AB. We can write slope of AB is equal to slope of AC. Now, what is the slope of AC? We are having minus f of A divided by C minus A is equal to slope of AB. What we are having? F of B minus f of A divided by B minus A. Okay. Now, we want the value of C. Okay. Because C is nothing but the root. So, using these two equations, we have to find these values C. Okay. So, for that, we can take the inverse of this. Or you can take ratio for this. Because we want the value of C. So, we want this term in the numerator. So, if you take the reciprocal, what you will get? C minus A divided by minus f of A. If you are taking reciprocal, here also we have to take the reciprocal. So, you will get B minus A divided by f of B minus f of A. Okay. Now, transfer this minus f of A on that side. If you transfer minus f of A on that side, see, in this side it is divided by. So, if you want to transfer on the other side, you will get it is multiplied by. So, you will get C minus A as it is equal to minus f of A into B minus A. Into B minus A divided by the denominator term as it is. F of B minus F of A. We want exactly the value of C. So, you will get C is equal to. If you want to transfer this minus A on that side, you will get it is plus A. So, I will write directly A. A and this term minus F of A into B minus A divided by F of B minus F of A. Okay. Exactly, we want the value of C. So, for that, here we have taken first reciprocal. So, numerator becomes denominator, denominator becomes numerator. Similarly, for this side also. Then, transfer this minus f of A on this side. Here it is divided by, so you will get here it is multiply. So, minus f of A into this term divided by denominator as it is. Now, again, transfer this minus on that side, you will get it is plus A. So, we are having these two terms. Now, we will take the LCM and solve. Okay. Because here A is one term and this f of A b minus a divided by f of b minus f of a is one term. So if you take LCM is this term, f of eb minus f of a. Okay, if this is your LCM, here we have divided by 1. So we have to take the cross product for this. So a into this term. So you will get a into f of b minus f of a. Okay, minus, here we are having the same term. So you have this term into 1, you will get this term itself. So you will get f of a into b minus a. Okay, take the LCM. Here we are having divided by 1. Because a divided by 1 is nothing but a only. So you will get LCM is f of b minus f of a. Take the cross product. You will get a into this term minus this into this. Because 1 into any term is that term itself. Now multiply this term inside. You will get a into f of b minus again a into f of a. Multiply the term inside. A into f of b minus as it is a into f of a. Here also we have to multiply this minus f of a inside. So minus into plus is minus. So you will get b into f of a. Minus into minus, you will get it is plus a into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. Now solve this. See, here we are having minus a f of a plus a f of a. Both terms are equal, but they are opposite in sign, so they get cancelled. So write down the remaining term only now. So we are having remaining term is a into f of b minus this term b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a, and this is the value of c. This is the formula to find the roots. See, in the bisection method it is very easy to find the roots. If you know the value of a and b, directly we find c is equal to what? A plus b divided by 2. But here we have to use this formula, a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. Substitute this value, calculate this, you will get the value of c. Okay, so same, whatever you did in the bisection method, again we have to make one table. Instead of c is equal to a plus b by 2, you will get c is equal to this formula. Okay, then using that formula, we have to find the solution. So this is the formula to find the root using regular Falsi method. Now we will say how working rule for this problem, what we have to do. This method and bisection method problems are nearly equivalent. Only the formula is changed for c. In the bisection method, we find c is equal to a plus b by 2. Here, we have to use this formula. Okay. So, suppose if, again, f of x is equal to 0 be the given equation. Okay. Either it is transcendental or algebraic. Then, we have to find the interval a comma b again. We have to find the value of a and b such that same f of a and f of b should be opposite in sign. Means, if you are taking product of this, we want it is less than, because either it is positive or negative, or it is negative or it is positive. So our first step is we have to find the interval a comma b such that f of a and f of b are opposite in sign. One is positive, one is negative. Then we have to find the root using the formula c is equal to a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. See, if you know the interval a comma b, in there only we find f of a and f of b. So you will get the value of f of a and f of b, and we get the value of a and b also. Substituted in this formula, we will get the value of c. Okay, so you will get your first root. If you find c, then we have to find f of c. Same, whatever you did in the bisection method, same method here we have to apply. So here also we have to find the f of c using this equation. Instead of x, in the given equation we have to substitute this value. You will get the value of f of c. So again, suppose if your, okay, this is your first approximation. Okay, next, to go for the next approximation, suppose if you are having your f of c is less than 0. Okay, f of c is less than 0, that is f of c is negative. Then we have to take the root from this a and b, for which we are having f of x is positive. Suppose here if you are having f of a is positive, then here we have to take the next root lies between c and a. Okay, but suppose if your f of a is negative and f of b is positive, then here we have to take that is b. So c and b, the root lies between c and b. Okay, so suppose if f of c is greater than 0, means if f of c is positive, then we have to take the root from this such that for which f of x is positive. Means again we want these two should be opposite in sign. Same whatever we use in the bisection method we have to apply here. So again you will get the next root. Continue this process till you will get the root of the desired accuracy. Means if they said find up to 50th ration, find up to 50th ration. If they said up to third, up to third. Or if they said up to 3 decimal places, then we have to find up to 3 decimal places. So this is all about the regular Falsi method. So this is the formula to find. See, if you compare both the method, only the difference is here you will get the, to find the root you will get the different formula. And in the bisection method we are having simply a plus b by 2. Okay. So we will see the problem depend on this regular Falsi method in the next class.